I got about 10 pounds of French fries just stored up and ready to be consumed in my kitchen, dude. This is incredible. Good Lord. Welcome back to another episode of $3 Down, ladies and gentlemen. But I ordered some wings tonight from this local wing place. I was feeling some wings, dude. It was for my entire family. It was going to be our dinner. And I ordered two large fries with the order of wings. With the order of wings, dude. I figured, two large fries, I think that'll be enough for our family. I figured there were going to be like fries that, you know, like a normal size large fry, you know, like how some local places, they put their fries in a little paper bag, in a big paper bag. I thought it was going to be something like that, dude. I get the food like 30 minutes later, and they are two individual boxes, literal just containers of French fries, man. Cooked, crispy, incredibly seasoned French fries. I cannot believe my eyes, dude. I was only feeding four people, man. We still have so many French fries in that kitchen. It's incredible. I mean, granted, those French fries are delicious. Those French fries are really good. They gave us some ranch with the wings too, so I'm over here just snacking on them, dipping them in the ranch. My God, dude, they are really good, but good Lord, we have so many French fries. Note to self, If I ever order there again, just get one large fry. Jesus Christ. If I'm feeding my entire family, one large fry, that's too much for one person, dude. The amount they give you is way too much, dude. Good Lord. I can't believe I wasted some money on that nonsense, dude. All we needed was one. All one would have been enough. We would have still had some left with one, dude. This is insane, man. Good Lord. It's a good thing those fries are really good. The whole thing was good. Their wings were pretty good, dude. We were going to go to Wingstop, but I think they're only doing like online orders or something now, or like orders through the app only. I think. I don't know if they're still doing that. I just remember that being the case like a couple weeks ago, and I just haven't been back there. So I figured, let's try this place. This place down the street. Haven't been there in a good while, dude. My God, there were so many people there. I ordered over the phone too, dude, and I waited like 30 minutes, and I drove up, and I saw there were so many cars sitting in front of the place. It was ridiculous, dude. Literally a line of people just stretching outside of the building. It was ridiculous. I was like, oh my God. I've been there before, and it was never that packed, dude. Good Lord. I was there on New Year's Eve a couple years ago, dude, and there was like hardly anybody in there. I don't know what they changed that they're so popular now, but good Lord, there were so many people, dude. After waiting like 10 minutes to finally get my turn at the cashier's counter, I still had to wait like an extra 5 minutes because my order wasn't even done, dude. I was like, oh my God. Good Lord, dude. I mean, granted, I did order like a good amount of stuff. I ordered 40 wings and two large fries. 40 wings because usually the amount of wings I get like at Wingstop or whatever would be 40 because I'm feeding four people. So that's 10, 10, 10, and 10, 40 wings. And at Wingstop, I usually get two large fries. So I treated this place the same way I would treat Wingstop. Get 40 wings, 10 for everybody, and get two large fries. Two people share one, two people share the other. I thought that's how it was gonna go, dude. I didn't know they were gonna give me two humongous buckets worth of French fries. I'm like, good God, dude. Good Lord. They're lucky those French fries are good, man. Those French fries are really good. Jesus Christ. And it was actually pretty, like, I thought it was gonna cost a bit more, dude. They told me the price, it was only like $50, which for all that food is not too bad. That order, if I would have like placed that at Wingstop, I'm pretty sure it would be close to like $70. Good Lord, man. But $50, that ain't too shabby for 40 wings, like four different flavors, and two ginormous things of fries, dude. That's not too shabby. $50, that ain't too bad. The flavors I got were mild buffalo wings, lemon pepper, garlic parmesan, and honey barbecue. I got mild because I didn't know how hot their original hot was. I didn't want to get hot and they would be like too hot, and we weren't going to be able to enjoy the wings because my dad can't really handle too spicy food anymore. I don't like spicy food too much. I don't mind it, but it, like, I don't go out of my way to eat it. My mom doesn't like it too much. My sister tolerates it, so I just got mild, dude. That was the only thing on their menu I cared to try. So I got mild, lemon pepper, garlic parmesan, which is absolutely... Their garlic parmesan is really good, Jesus Christ. And their barbecue. I enjoy those two the most. Garlic parmesan and barbecue. Oh my God, those were really good, dude. With some ranch, you dip those things in some ranch, man. Oh, that was some good stuff. That was some good stuff. There's still a few wings in there. Good Lord, man. After I finish recording this episode, I think I'll go back and get some more, though. I feel like I'm going to explode if, like, I get stung by a mosquito or some nonsense. I'm on the verge of spontaneous combustion, to be honest, man. I don't even know how I'm living right now. Jesus Christ. I ate way too much, but it feels good, man. I was really hungry. I hadn't eaten too much. That's an absolute lie. My job had a Thanksgiving luncheon today, and I chowed down on a bunch of food. But still, that was early, much earlier in the day, and I was very hungry. I can't believe I'm over here lying on my own podcast, dude. This is incredible. You see how quick I was to just lie? Well, I wasn't lying, all right? That was just a slip of the tongue. Just a slip of the mind, all right? That wasn't a lie. I just forgot about that whole ordeal because it was pretty... It wasn't too bad, but it's not really worth remembering. The luncheon... They didn't have to do the luncheon, you know what I mean? They did it out of the kindness of their heart, but my God, the food was... Not that good, to be honest. I mean, food is food. I still ate it. Free food is free food. I don't mind that. But it was a Thanksgiving luncheon, and the only really good thing they had was their mac and cheese. They catered from this one place. I'm not gonna name it, but they catered from this place, and good Lord, dude, their food is not too good. Not too good. I'm not gonna lie. Their turkey. Oh my God, their turkey was so bad. It was so bad, it's not even funny. So bad, dude. Jesus Christ. Their turkey, it was like cardboard, like wet cardboard. See, turkey is that kind of poultry, dude. Like, it's really hit or miss, to be honest. Turkey, it's either really good or really bad. That there is no in between, to be honest, with turkey. And unfortunately, in this case, it was really... really bad, like really bad. I'm telling you, it tasted like wet cardboard. It was bland. It was incredibly overcooked. All the slices were very thin. It was like I was eating literally like a piece of paper, dude. It was crazy how bad the turkey was. Jesus Christ. They had stuffing. Their stuffing was absolutely horrendous. Jesus Christ. It just tasted like bland bread. But I mean, dude, it wasn't too bad. And once you smother it in gravy, it gets masked by the gravy, and the gravy kind of saves it. But like by itself, absolutely just bleh, to be honest, man. Like I said, the only really good thing they had was their mac and cheese. Their mac and cheese was pretty good. But I mean, it's well, not really. I was about to say it's kind of hard to go wrong with mac, but I have had many a mac and cheese where it's absolutely just terrible, dude. You would think something so simple as mac and cheese would be pretty easy to nail every time, but you'd be surprised how many people are absolutely horrendous at making mac and cheese, dude. But in this case, it was pretty good. Their mac and cheese was the best thing they had, to be honest, man. They had a whole bunch of desserts, too, that didn't come from this place they catered from. One of the managers just went and bought a whole bunch of cookies and cakes from Kroger or whatever, which was nice. I stole so many sodas. Well, I didn't steal them. They were there to take if you wanted them. So I just went up there. Like, I got two sodas initially to eat my food with for the first go around. Then I waited a bit, you know, let everyone else get some food. Then I went back up there and I saw there was a whole bunch of soda still left. I looked around, made sure no one saw me, and I got a little plastic bag and filled that thing up with sodas, dude. With sodas and water bottles. Good Lord, they had Diet Coke in there. I don't even drink Diet Coke or anything diet for that matter, but I still took it. Soda, dude, I'll still take it. They held a whole bunch of Coke, Sprite, water bottles. They had Crush, Orange Crush, whole bunch of good stuff in there, dude. Barring the diet stuff, not too shabby. I made off with a pretty good haul, man. But other than that, the lunch, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't, well, it was, eh, it was all right. It was all right, dude. This makes me kind of sound like an ungrateful bastard, but I'm just being honest, dude. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you and say this was the greatest luncheon I've ever had in my entire life. It wasn't that good. It is what it is. It just wasn't that good, man. Unfortunate, but that's just the way it goes sometimes. Good Lord. But I mean, like I said, hey, free food is free food, man. Free food is free food. Dude, how in God's name, why does my body hate me so much, dude? Why does it hate me so much? I woke up at 4 in the morning, man. Remember, I gotta wake up like at 6 in the morning to get ready for work, which isn't super, super omega early, but I mean, I go to bed like at 1. I go to bed like at 1 in the morning, and I'm over here waking up at 4 in the morning because I just feel an omega pain coursing through my thigh, dude. I woke up because I have just been smacked in the face by the Charlie Horse demon. I got hit with a Charlie horse in the middle of the night while I was unconscious in blissful, peaceful sleep, dude. I have not gotten a Charlie horse in so long. I don't know what happened, man. I don't know what I did to trigger a Charlie horse. The pain was unbearable. Seriously, it was just ridiculous. I just shot out of bed and I tripped and fell on the floor, like wrapped up in my covers. I'm trying to soothe my thigh by like rubbing my thigh, or trying to position it in a way where it can like alleviate the cramp, but I just can't get it, dude. I can't get it. So I slowly climb up and hobble my way out, and I go to my dad, because my dad, he, you know how dads are, they wake up really early for some reason and they take a nap later on in the day for the rest of the day. So I went in there and I hobbled my way in there. I'm like, Pops, you got any pain relief stuff? He's like, what's wrong with you? I said, I got a Charlie horse, man. I got a cramp. Please help me out. He's like, yeah, hold on. Let me get a pain pill. I was like, okay, thank you. Thank you. He gave me the pain pill. I took it and I tried to lay back down in bed, but every time I laid or tried to stretch my leg out, the pain would just absolutely accelerate tenfold. So I had to sit there on the side of my bed for about 10 minutes. It's 10 minutes until the pain pill kicked in and the pain started going away, dude. I'm just sitting there in the dark, just got the biggest frown on my face, dude, just hoping, praying for this pain to go away, because I want to go back to sleep. I need to go back to sleep, dude. Good Lord. Apparently, like I read before, apparently cramps like this can be triggered due to a lack of water, or like strenuous exercise, or lack of exercise. But I mean, I drink so much water, dude. I only drink water. I don't drink, well, I mean, other than like that soda I had earlier today. I only had a soda because, you know, Thanksgiving lunch, you might as well have a soda, dude. But other than that, I really only just drink water. I don't drink much else, dude, just water. So I'm like, why? That can't be it, dude. I stay hydrated really, really well. Strenuous exercise? I don't really do too much stuff that's like really strenuous. I do walk upstairs a lot every day. I walk up a bunch of stairs a lot. But I mean, I've been doing that for months now, dude, and I haven't had a Charlie horse. Lack of exercise? That there's just no way. Like I said, I walk upstairs every day, almost all day, dude. So how can the lack of exercise be? How can the strenuous exercise be when I do it? I have been doing it for months. I don't know what caused the Charlie horse. Maybe I positioned my thigh in such a way during my sleep where it just cramped out on its own. I don't know what happened, man. Good Lord. But there is nothing worse than getting a Charlie horse in the middle of the night when everybody's asleep, when you're asleep, dude. I don't mind getting a Charlie horse when I'm up and awake. Like, if I were to get a Charlie horse right now, I wouldn't mind it too much. Obviously, I don't want a Charlie horse, but if I'm gonna have a Charlie horse, I would like it to happen when I'm up and awake, you know what I mean? Not when I'm asleep and then just shooting me out of bed, and I can't even, like, I'm over here, like, just like, into my pillow because I don't want to wake anybody up, dude. There is no worse feeling than just waking up in pain like that, in a searing pain like that, dude. Knowing you can't like yell out or anything. You gotta like, oh my God, into the pillow as quiet as you can. That's hard to do, man. That is incredibly hard to do. But if it would have happened like right now, no one would care, dude. No one would care. It wouldn't be that much of a problem. Yeah, it'd be annoying, but I mean, if it's gonna happen, at least smack me with it when I'm up and about, you know what I mean? Stop doing it when I'm asleep. That's the only time that happens. Absolute coward. My own body is a coward, dude. You are a coward. If you're gonna attack me, if my own body is gonna work against me, at least do it when I'm up, all right? Stop doing this to me, dude. Waiting till I'm asleep, waiting till I'm in my most vulnerable position, in my most comfortable position, to smack me with something so painful, something so raw. I can't believe this nonsense, man. Good Lord. Absolutely ridiculous. I've been sitting here like chugging water because maybe that's the only thing I can think of that maybe triggered the Charlie horse, is the apparent lack of water, which is, I find that hard to believe, but like I can't imagine the lack of exercise or the strenuous exercise being the culprit in this situation. The water is the only thing I can think of. So I've been sitting here just drinking water nonstop, and let's hope when I go to bed that it never happens again. Well, at least it doesn't happen again tonight. But if it does, don't worry, I will update. I will update. Literally, the pain was so bad, the spot where the Charlie horse occurred, ground zero, it is still raw. It literally hurts to touch, dude. That's how painful it was. I have been going all throughout the day with that pain still in my thigh. I'm like, Jesus, dude, what in God's name happened? Good Lord. And I've been trying, this is gonna be my goal for like the next few episodes and next few videos I upload on YouTube. I gotta find a way to incorporate the word phantasmagorical. I need to find a way to incorporate that word seamlessly into a sentence I say, either during the podcast or during a video I record for YouTube, dude. Phantasmagorical. That is a powerful word. That is an incredibly powerful word. But like, you can't, it's kind of hard to just have a normal sentence that includes the word phantasmagorical be and have it be absolutely seamless, you know what I mean? Phantasmagorical, dude. That is an incredible word. I saw it while watching a Baki video, man. Like, I'm over here watching this LR Shion video, and he's narrating over this Miyamoto Musashi reincarnated dude, and he says the word phantasmagorical. I'm like, what in God's name does that even mean, dude? I had to Google it. Phantasmagorical, that is a powerful word. Jesus Christ. Apparently it means having a fantastic or deceptive appearance, as something in a dream or created by the imagination, having the appearance of an optical illusion, especially one produced by a magical lantern, or by a magic lantern. What in God's name? Changing or shifting as a scene made up of many elements. That is phantasmagorical, dude, or phantasmagoria. That is powerful, man. That is powerful. So, if you ever just hear me say the word phantasmagorical, or phantasmagoric, or phantasmagoria, don't be surprised, because I'm trying. That is my little side quest, my little sub quest, dude, to try to fit in the word phantasmagorical into any sentence I say from now on. Good Lord, man. But that's gonna do it for me today. But before we go, we must recommend a song. The song we're gonna recommend is a song I have had on repeat for the past few days, dude. As many of you know, Necrogoblicon is one of my favorite bands right now. Necrogoblicon, they are incredibly powerful, ridiculously powerful, and they just released a new single. The name of the song we are recommending on this fine day is Right Now by Necrogoblicon. They just released the song pretty recently, dude. Right Now by Necrogoblicon. This song is awesome. This song is really good, dude. Really good. Necrogoblicon, Right Now. Not too shabby, dude. Not too shabby at all. But that's going to do it for me today. If you enjoyed today's episode, please be sure to share this podcast on social media. Be sure to follow it if you have the ability to do so. Once this video is up on YouTube, please be sure to like and subscribe. And if you want, in the description of this podcast is a link. You click that link, it'll take you to Anchor, and you can record a voice clip. I will receive that voice clip, and if it's, you know, suitable to have on the podcast, I will have it on the podcast. And whatever question you have, or if you just want to say something nice, I'll put it in the podcast, dude, as long as it is, you know, suitable for the podcast. You know, don't be a weirdo. Don't send any, you know, not safe for working nonsense. So we'll see how that goes, dude. It's in the description of this podcast, wherever you're listening to this podcast on. Go ahead, send it in if you want to. Good Lord. Make sure you have a pretty good mic, though. I don't want to hear some static, all right? That's all I got to say about that. But thank you very much for listening, and I will see you all later. Goodbye.